that small one there?
No, I need it. Honey?
Yeah.
We don't do anything anymore.
Huh?
Well, it's been almost a year.
That's not true.
Why don't we?
We do.
No, we don't.
We do in my version of things.
What does that mean?
It means I love you.
I know. That's not what I'm talking about. You remember when I got up Saturday morning to take a shower? Well, I saw you. I didn't know that you were waiting for me to leave.
Honey, I wasn't... Oh, honey, I wasn't waiting for you to leave. Honey, so what?
What? So I haven't seen that look on your face in a really long time. At least not for me, you know? I mean, you're always saying you're too tired, but you're not too tired.
Oh, I'm too tired for this. Hey. I love you. I love you. I love you, and too bad that's not enough.
Oh, that's such bullshit.
You want to lay this on me, but it's you too.
I never said it wasn't.
Tonight I lack the strength to even move. When you walked, and I watched it die. But I know this is hard for you. For love has laid you.
Are you still attracted?
Why are we not enough anymore?
You never had to ask me. I always wanted to kiss you.
boys.
No, honey, you act like you do, but you don't.
On our anniversary?
Yeah,
did
you
I
had
really
to.
Did have to?
Yes, because that's a crock. I mean, what am I supposed to do? Why is it all on me? I guess, yeah, you know what? I should be in the mood every time I clean out the gecko cage. Everybody else is, it seems. You know what else turns me on? I'll tell you what turns me on. Buying Cheerios is really hot. And then, of course, going and getting shoelaces or fantasizing about minivans. That's sexy, too. I really want to do that. It's excellent foreplay. Or, you know what else is good foreplay? When you are comparing apple juice prices and they both don't even want to be in the grocery store, but you know you got to get back because they got to be fed before they go to bed. And then at bed, all you're doing is just reading to them, probably and telling them the same goddamn story for the 100th time. Then, after all that, then I am ready to have sex, because all that is so hot.
Our entire life. That's what you just trashed. Our entire life.
Sex has been hanging over my goddamn head for I don't know how long. Every time I look at you, you have this look in your eyes like, are you gonna have sex with me?
Really?
Yeah, really.
You know what? Don't worry about it anymore because I will never.
One night I looked over and I didn't want her. And I didn't know why. And I didn't know what to do. You can't tell your wife you don't want her anymore and recover.
No, but you can tell her that you're lost and you don't know what to do.
Does it come back? And does it? Once you've gotten to the point where we are, can it come back? Remember the woman I met?
Yeah, but you know what?
I haven't forgotten.
Well, that's the problem. I don't want to be who you see. That's not who I want to be.
I didn't just come out of the box like this.
This is 12 long years of not always doing what I want to do either.
Then leave.
Fuck you.
Someone once told my husband and me that no one else could be in our relationship. And I think that's true. And also that we had to find the courage to be happy. And I think that's true too. The one thing a therapist can do, perhaps in times of darkness, is turn a light on. And I think we've accomplished that. The trick now is not to be so stunned by the glare that you want to turn it back off.